College of Idaho is welcoming its largest international class in its history this year. There will be 120 students on campus representing some 70 different countries. As Six on Your Side's Michelle Edmonds explains, three of those students who were caught between a rock and a hard place are particularly happy to call themselves Yotes in tonight's Making the Grade.
You may not understand what these students are saying, but you can definitely read their mood. The teenagers from Nepal are spending their first days in the United States attending the College of Idaho.
And the U.S. is like a land of opportunities.
The small private Caldwell school was not their first choice. The University of Texas at Tyler offered just over 100 Nepal students full ride scholarships, including these three. But a few months later, UT Tyler backed out.
I couldn't believe it at first, to be honest.
The Texas administrators called it, quote, a perfect storm. Too many Nepal students accepted, and there wasn't enough money in the budget. By the time UT Tyler rescinded the full rides, many of the Nepal students had already turned down other U.S. colleges.
We didn't have any other options, and that was like we didn't have anywhere to go.
To make matters worse, the students found out their scholarships were canceled at the end of April on the Nepalese New Year.
I mean, it is 1 a.m. in the morning in the
Nepal,
and it's the New Year. And people are celebrating, and the bad news arrived. That's pretty brutal, yes.
My immediate reaction is, wow, the timing couldn't be worse.
Brian Bava is the vice president of enrollment for the Yotes. He says the plight of the highly gifted Nepal students quickly spread through the tight-knit college admissions community.
It was disappointing from a professional standpoint, but it was heartbreaking, too.
We had already set up our dreams and planned our future somewhat about our education.
Like most colleges, C of I had already closed its admissions, but administrators made an exception. They offered three students placement, agreeing to pay their tuition and some room and board.
I mean, I'm pretty confident that these students in Nepal didn't know much about Idaho. That says a lot to me about the types of people they are and the, you know, risk takers, leaders. Those are the types of people you want in a campus community.
The grateful students arrived with gifts to thank the College of Idaho staff.
And then this is the country of Nepal, as well as their flag, the Nepali flag.
These three say the Treasure Valley reminds them of their country, which keeps them from being homesick.
It's like American Nepal or something like that.
Yes.
we can call that because there are a lot of mountains up here, and that's the same in Nepal as well.
And if you need more proof of how they're acclimating, just ask what they like best about school.
I really like the food.
Yes, I was thinking about food.
Yeah, it is quite beautiful.
I love it, the pool. Uh-huh. I was going to ask about the food.
Food is best out here.
Food is the best.
Hands down, it's the best.
Typical college students, like they always dreamed.
UT Tyler's chief communications officer told me the school has implemented new protocols to make sure this sort of oversight that affected these students never happens again. If you have a Making the Grade education story, I'd love to hear about it. You can send me an email or a message on Facebook. Michelle Edmonds, Six on Your Side.